I'm Kay Ward, and this is your smart decorator's tip. And actually, you caught me looking in my book. And this book is actually one that we use to take our 2017 holiday custom orders. And it's for folks that want to come in and they want to make a wreath with maybe this bow combined with that berry, or a centerpiece, or a porch pot, or something like that. And we can do that for them for custom, but maybe you want to do it yourself. And that's where we can help you as well. So let me show you what we can do. So say we wanted to do a wreath. Well, I happen to have one here. And you'd start with a blank, because the cool thing about wreaths or anything else, it's like a blank slate. And you can put anything on it to customize it exactly how you would like that fits not only your home and your decor styles, but also your budget. So you would look at those pieces depending on how you'd want that to work out for you. So here I have a beautiful 10-inch frame wreath, which finishes about 20 inches. So that said, well, what do I do from there? Well, I want to choose things that I like. So I have a whole selection. It's just a small example of the things that we have here at the Garden Center, whether it be more natural, like this birch wreath, birch bow, actually. So this looks like birch pieces that we could put on here, to a natural pine cone that might go with that, to, look at this, raspberries and things. So it's really up to you what you want to put together. Well, Kate, maybe I don't want to buy a bow. Maybe I want to do it myself. No problem. All you'd have to do is choose a ribbon that you like, and again, you can customize it. So here we have, this is a wide ribbon that is the most standard size used, but on this wreath, because it's a little bit smaller, I can also get away with using this narrow. Well, what do I do from there? That's great. If you can't remember, we have these here, how to make a fluffy bow, or just ask us. But for a quick lesson, pretty easy. It's a pinch, a twist, and a loop. Now this one, your first one, I'm gonna loop, I'm gonna pinch it, twist it so it's right side up, and I'm always twisting the same direction. They all go left or they all go right, you gotta choose. But then I make a loop, I pinch it, and I twist, and I make a loop, I pinch, and I twist. And it's just that easy. Now that said, you're gonna need a little practice, but don't worry about it. Practice makes perfect, and that's how you get there. So that said, I get my bow. I get it to the size that I want, that I like for my wreath. Now, this isn't fully finished. I put a wire through the center and call it done. But how am I gonna choose my tails? How do I like my tails? Usually, they're as long as halfway through the bottom section. Well, maybe I don't want tails. So I might put it on, and I might buy extra ribbon, and I'm just gonna tuck it through the wreath somehow. Maybe my bow's gonna be on the bottom and hang down. Infinite possibilities. So the other thing I might do is I get that in there, and again, customize it. I might get a pick and I might cut it apart so that it makes it bigger. Hot glue is your friend here, unless you put it on your fingers and then it stinks. It's not a good friend. But aside from that, it works wonders, and it's so fast and it's so easy that you can do it. And remember, we're here to help anytime. If you need us to help you, we'd be happy to do so. And this has been your Dickman Farms Smart Decorator Tip.